Welcome back. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, add a comment, and smash the like button to support this channel. Thanks. This is lesson 9 of the book Residential Design Using Autodesk Revit 2024. I will start by opening lesson 8, Revit project, and then saving as lesson 9. So what is lesson 9 about? It's about floor systems and reflected ceiling plans or ceilings, so floors and ceilings. So using the floor command, right, structural floor, I will use concrete slab 4 inches type in order to pick walls and pick the inside surface of all the basement walls in the basement floor plan. And once I have a closed polygon all the way around, I can finish the command, and that will create a floor slab in the basement. I do not want to cut the walls, so always say no to that. So that's the floor in the basement. I go to my first floor plan, close down my basement, and then use the same command to add the floor. So it's the floor, structural floor, the floor type in the garage is the same as the basement. So it's a 4-inch concrete slab. I'll use the pick lines tool to pick the outside face of the wall here in this case, and then make sure that I have picked all the inside surfaces, and I will give it a negative offset of -6 inches or so from the main house, because the garage floor needs to be lower in order to avoid flooding. So we don't want to attach this to anything. This cross symbol is the structural span direction, which we'll need to delete. Okay. Same thing for the basement level. We need to delete that span direction. All right, back to the first floor. I'm thinking here, what do I do? Okay, first floor command, architectural snow structure. Architectural, okay. So why architectural? Because it's the floor that has a wood finish. So it could be structural too. But for the most part, that's the hardwood floor. We will trim all the corners, make sure everything is right. And we will give it, we can give it a height offset from the floor, from the level if you want, but we don't want to attach to anything. We don't want to create any kind of cuts, and that's the hardwood floor. I mean, ideally speaking, this would be raised about 3/4 inch of the level. Okay, second floor plan, same thing. Same process for the second floor plan. Select, pick walls, and go around and select all the interior surfaces of the exterior wall. Trim the corners. And finish the command. And no, don't cut anything. Right, so this is the easiest way to do this assignment. Because we chose the architectural floor, we're not going to get any span direction, this big cross in the middle. All right, so what I'm doing now is editing the floor and making sure that I have I've traced the edges of the staircase in order to create the stair opening. So what does the stair opening look like. It's essentially an island made up of these, selecting the edges of the staircase. It needs to be a closed loop though. So if I finish the command, it's going to give me an error message telling me to go back and fix, trim those corners. I'm not being too careful about the exact location, but that's how you create a floor opening for the staircase. I will need to do the same thing on the lower level. So I go to the first floor plan, same thing, edit boundary, and simply trace the corners. Now, when you do this assignment yourself, you want to do it a little bit more carefully to avoid any issues, but you know, I am moving a little bit faster than usual. Now, in the case on the right-hand side where I have the opening in the wall, I do not want to extend the opening beyond the edges of that. So same thing here, I need to trim all these corners first. You can tell that my work is a little bit sloppy because I'm not paying attention to the detail. So don't attach, don't cut anything, just keep it the way it is. So this is the opening for the first floor slab, and it is it's got an issue with the way the stairs meet with the slab, but I'm just going to keep going here. Now I'm going now to the first floor RCP plan to add my ceiling. And Revit wants to add a ceiling for the entire floor. I don't want that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that these partitions are high enough. So I'm select all the partitions and change their top constraint to second floor. And then I may give them a top offset of minus 10 inches. Okay, let's see if that works. Yep, that works. Okay, so I'll start by adding, I can add a 2x4 acoustic system using the ceiling command, or I can add a gypsum wallboard on fairing, right? And then you do want to create only one click inside of each of those rooms. If you keep clicking, you end up with multiple ceilings in the same location, so you don't want that. If you can't see the ceiling, you may want to go back and I'm using the align command to align the edge of this partition here. That's not related to the ceiling issue. It needs to be done. This will update all the dimensions, will update all the partitions, all the plans. So it's good stuff. This is the part of Revit that I like very much. All right, so now we have these this ceiling. That we also need to create an island, right? And that island is going to be the opening. It's not enough to have an opening in the floor. You need to have an opening in the ceiling as well. You can't go upstairs unless you have an opening in the ceiling. So you don't want to leave any gaps. You want to keep trimming all the corners. There's a corner at the bottom. Okay, here we go. So now Revit shows me where the problem is. Okay, so now we have an opening in the ceiling as well. Great, so that's the first floor RCP plan. Let's go to the second floor RCP plan and do the same thing. We will need to... I'm changing the ceiling height to 10 feet. And selecting the entire ceiling, all the ceilings, Check none. Select all the ceilings, 6 of them, changing their height from the floor to be 10 feet. Remember, the floor-to-floor height we have is 12 feet, so we can do the ceilings at 10 feet. That's how it should be, really. Anything less than 10 feet looks, you know, does not feel very good. I would say 9 is the lowest and 10 is ideal or higher. Same thing for the garage. We're adding a ceiling at 10 feet. Now, without the ceiling, it would be difficult for you to add light fixtures. On the second floor plan, we want to change all the partition heights to go from the second floor to the roof level. We want to give them a top offset of minus 10 inches, or I missed that step, but that's okay. Now we can add the ceilings, 2x4 acoustic system in the home office, and then a gypsum wallboard and fairing in the other rooms. Again, one click in each room is enough. Don't keep clicking. And you can see here, this space, we'll try to do, as the book says, open to above. We'll add a text note with leader to that space. We'll just say open to above or open to structure above. We'll add another leader and stretch it over so that looks like professional drafting here. And we have all the ceilings, we have all the floors, we have all the openings. So we need a ceiling plan for the basement. So I'll use the ceiling plan command, select the basement level, and then same thing. We will need to add ceilings in each room, but in this case, we'll just do it manually using the sketch ceiling. This will be a 2x4 acoustic tile at 10 feet. And then in the rest of the rooms, we can just add the ceiling. We'll just use a gypsum wallboard. The reason we're using a 2x4 acoustic tile is because, you know, just to show some variety of things, you know. It's not necessarily required for residential. Trimming the corners and then stretching it to the location. So you can do automatic ceilings or you can do sketch ceilings. It's up to you. All right, so we're loading here a ceiling height with tag, or a ceiling tag with height from the annotations folder, and we're going to tag by category and then uncheck the box for leader, free end, no leader, and then go ahead and place it where it belongs. Yeah, some of this video is fast forwarded, so you don't have to wait for everything. So we're tagging all the ceilings, and it will give us the height. And you really wanted the ceilings to be at 10 feet, you know, for the most part. And that tag can be moved if you want to. Okay, so what we're doing here is that we're going to move this tag over and create a raised ceiling in the middle of the basement, not in the first floor, in the basement level. Here we go. I'm going to hide all these elevation tags in all the views. Hide by category. And go back to the basement. So if you want, you can slow down this video or speed it up depending on your needs, but you know, this is normal speed of the video. I know it looks kind of fast, too fast sometimes and too slow sometimes, depending on whether I'm thinking about it or just doing it. So I'm going to place a camera in the basement level so I can see the raised ceiling in the basement. So there's nothing going on there that's at the moment, but so put this RCP plan next to the 3D camera view, and we're going to edit that 2x4 acoustic ceiling and then add a circular island that will be our opening. I'm not going to spend too much time make it perfect, so I'm just going to eyeball it for now. So any island inside that ceiling will become an opening, just like for the stairs. So if this was a home theater room, you want this to be like a nice fancy raised ceiling. So we will add another ceiling. We'll match. I'm using a SC to snap to the center of the circle. Object snaps, and that's the gypsum wallboard on fairing ceiling, which is at 11 feet height from the level, right? I'm adding a soffit wall. Is a wall type in Revit called soffit wall that I will use to snap to the inside of the opening. And I was having issues with the visibility here, so when I turn on the hidden line, I'm not seeing the raised ceiling. So this is why I decided to move the tag outside the building so that it's not in the way. And then edit the tag itself and add a leader arrowhead. This could be a dot filled. I think I use dot filled 1/8 inch for that, or even smaller size. Or a target. I think this is a target. Yeah. It's whatever you want to use. Okay, so the purpose of this is to create a two-level ceiling and then create a soffit wall and then add light fixtures and diffusers, supply and return air terminals. At this point, I'm adding in some lighting fixtures. I'm going to bring in some internal light fixtures such as a recessed can light, down light, recessed can, pendant light disc, a wall sconce, and sconce light, up light, and then a 2x4 parabolic truffle light, 2x4 parabolic. It's just for different types of light fixtures that will be used in a residential setting. Okay, so I'm trying to find an air terminal in the MEP folder, such as a supply or a return diffuser, and just to kind of illustrate what can be done here, right? Every room needs to have at least one supply or more. And it may have a return depending on where it's located in the building. So you want to check your placement, place on work plane, place on face. You want to place on face in this case, because you don't want the diffuser to go on the floor. I know this is like an overkill, but again, it's if you're designing this room, this as a home theater, you may want to include that as part of the. So these are four supply diffusers, but you know, you can be return diffusers if you want. So you want to align. Okay, I'm adding now the light fixtures. Let's start off with a 2x4 or a pendant, the pendant disc first for some reason. Put it in the middle of the circle. And a 2x up lights, cons light. Yeah, recess light. I'm gonna place two recess Lacan lights on this circle, inside the circle. Extend the reference plane, unpin, extend the reference plane, and then create another reference plane from the quadrant down, and to make sure we got the center of the circle, right? You want to pin those in place, you don't want to move anymore, and then you move that pendant light to the intersection. So you would use the SI snap intersection. Next, we'll do an array for these two recess can lights. So select the two recess can lights, use the array command, use the radial place, center of the circle, start, turn, 45 degrees, 8 count. Okay, so the count is 8. And that's how you place your recess can lights. I mean, this is just one solution of the to make a nice layout in the ceiling. It doesn't have to be this way, but it illustrates many different commands in Revit at the same time, you know, the array command and all the associated stuff. Again, you may want to slow down the video if this was too fast for you, and watch it step by step. Right, so now I'm placing the 2x4 light fixture, truffle light, 2x4 parabolic, and I'm going to use the rotate command to rotate it 90 degrees, and then use the align command to align it with the grid. We use the same thing for the diffusers and make sure it's aligned with the grid. And do that everywhere. Yeah, I wish this would snap automatically to the grid. It should, you know, but you would think that it would do that, but it doesn't. Especially if you work in a large building, this should be more automated. Okay, well, it looks like we have done quite a bit here. We just need to spread those light fixtures everywhere in the room. And this is not a beautiful design. It's just a way for me to show you how to copy those light fixtures, you know, from intersection to intersection of the grid. Right? That's the purpose of this. Okay, we're adding the sconce lights, sconce light, up light, and it's not easy to do that in the ceiling plan. We'll do that in the floor plan. We're just gonna add those, maybe a couple, maybe three or four on one side. And then mirror those to the other side, right? So once they are added, you can see them in the 3D view. Once they are added, you want to select them and then mirror them to the other side. You don't want to add all of them at the same time, because it won't be symmetrical. Okay. So that's it as far as the adding light fixtures and diffusers. When we're going to do the same thing in the second floor. Obviously, I'm not going to be able to place all the light fixtures that you want in every single floor plan in this video. So I'm going to try to be brief as possible. We'll see the end result of this at the in lesson 15. Just doing a double checking everything, making sure everything is working. I'm going to open my seating plans and my 3D view, and I'm going to do a window tile zoom all, WTZA, to show you the result of this lesson 9. And that's it for ceilings and floors. I will change the graphic display option to show ambient shadow in my 3D. And I'll see you in lesson 10. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, add a comment, and smash the like button to support this channel. Thanks.